guess what? The Germans were there before us. No England for us anymore. The Germans were there, but those were German soldiers. They didn't question, are you Jewish, are you Christian, are you whatever. They put us on these big army trucks. I'm sure you've seen movies with these great big army trucks, and we were hoisted on and taken back to Brussels. Now we were under the German. Jews were not allowed in public schools. Jews were not allowed in hospitals. Jews were not allowed, really, in any public places. And this is when I was issued this star. And this is how it was sewn on. And this is my original star. Because now we were under the German law. And that's when, like you heard in the movie, this young woman who was only 18, 19 years old, she and six other young women decided they were Catholics, they were going to the University of Brussels to make a difference. They approached the Archdiocese of Belgium and said, Monsignor, we have to help. These are innocent children. And that's how I was placed in this convent. And actually, I got a very good education. I was baptized. I was confirmed. And I followed Catholicism for about 2 years. And I felt very comfortable. And a lot of people have said to me, oh, the nuns made you convert. It's not true. Absolutely not true. Because out of all the children there, there was only six of us that converted and had baptism, had First Communion, followed. I liked the constant circumstance of all this. Choir. Sing. I just felt I was, like I said in the story, I was not different. I ever have to wear this stupid star again. I'm now, quote, normal. Because the way we were, that we were like bad people. We were like monsters. That's how German Hitler said, you know, we were terrible people. So I stayed actually Catholic for 2 years. I went to church every Sunday. And while I was in the convent, I followed it. And in those days, folks, you had to learn Latin because the prayer books were all in Latin. But Latin is very good if you want to learn a foreign language because it's based on a lot of words. So I stayed in that convent until one day this SS officer, like I said, appeared and asked the Mother Superior if she was hiding, not Jewish children, but parachutists, British parachutists, because that was in 1944. And I don't know if you've learned the history, but that was in June of 1944, when the D-Day, the landing of the British and American soldiers. And they had to look, I guess, where it's the best place to land, and where to walk on and go further. So the Mother Superior, of course, said, no, there's no British. Men here, this is a girls' school. We don't have men living here with the women, with the girls. And he left. But like I said, that Mother Superior was very smart, as much as she was very strict and staunch, but she was very smart. She gathered us and said, today he listened to me, the SS officer. Tomorrow he might not. and he might start asking you questions. And you have to remember, if you're under duress and you ask questions over and over and over, you're going to come out with the truth because you're scared. So she figured, get us out of here in case they come back tomorrow. Well, I never knew until again, 1991, at the first Hidden Children reunion, when they honored my rescuer and 20 other rescuers, that Mother Superior actually not only hid one parachutist, she hid two. There were actually two British parachutists hidden in that convent. After the war, she got so many accolades, also from the British government, because she saved those two guys' lives. So, you know, when I first was asked, actually, I never spoke about my past, the war, until 1991, which I have a disc that was made by ABC. Because when I came to San Francisco, 1947, I was issued an affidavit by an aunt that my father found after the war. It was a half-sister of my mother who immigrated. My mother, in other words, my grandmother, my grandfather was married twice. And this was from the first marriage, and they came to the United States. Then the second marriage, my grandmother stayed in Germany. And I never felt that my story was worth telling, because when I heard stories from people that came back from the camps, that escaped the ovens, I thought, me, I was in a school, in a boarding school, I had my meals, of course they were mostly vegetables, because the nuns grew a lot of vegetables. And I was, like I say, always say, a vegetarian, a vegan, before it was the in thing to be, because that's all we lived on. But I had food, and when I saw pictures of the people that came or heard stories that were in the camps, I said, what am I talking about? This is nothing what I went through. But each again, I lost my childhood. I lost being with my family. I was taken away, put with strangers, different environment. So, but when I came to the United States, my aunt told me when I first landed in San Francisco at the Ferry Building, I came from Brussels, London, Liverpool, New York, and took a train from New York to San Francisco. And I did all that at the age of 16, going on 17, by myself. And in those days, most of the ladies on the ship were warbrides. They were coming to meet their husbands to the United States. But my aunt said to me, in perfect German, she still spoke perfect German, she said, you're now in the United States. Forget what happened, because it's over and nobody cares.